smells spicy. What's up everyone, I'm Chris. We got Steph behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are here in the south of Mexico in the city of Oaxaca. This is one of the culinary capitals and top food destinations of the country. Oaxacan cuisine can be described as super diverse, unique, and full of flavor. So today we are starting our Oaxacan food tour off with a bang, and it all gets going right now. Come on. We're here this morning at a very local street food stall for a popular Oaxacan breakfast of memelas. And you can see behind me, they are cooking so many up. This place is packed behind me with locals eating breakfast here, so it must be a good spot. And there is a ton of toppings to put on these memelas, so let's go take a look and get a few.
Una de papa con chorizo y una de roja y una de papa con
rajas.
Con rajas, ajá. Y una de papa con chorizo. ¿No?
¿Tú qué
quieres?
No, no puedo.
Es una grasería.
¿Verdad? ¿Agua?
Sí.
Muchas gracias. Ah, wow, bellissimo. These guys look awesome. So we have our two memelas here, and we got one with potato and chorizo and quesillo cheese, as well as a fresher one with avocado, beef and tomatoes, along with that stringy cheese as well, that Oaxacan special cheese. These look amazing, and it's so cool because you can see them making the memela dough fresh right here. And what makes them super special is that they pinch the sides, you can see there, to keep all the toppings in. So it's almost kind of like a little plate for the toppings. And on the bottom, they spread frijoles, which is the refried beans. So these guys are packed. Mmm. That dough is so crispy, and I just love the pinch sides. It's just keeping everything on. But the potatoes are nice and soft. The chorizo add a nice meat flavor to that. And the quesillo, the cheese, oh. Mmm. Love that Oaxaca cheese. So stringy. Oh. Muy rico.
Gracias.
Oh, delicioso.
Oh.
These memelas are a really good breakfast. We got some live street music right over here as well now, but let's give this beef, avocado, and tomato memela a try. Look at that. Absolutely packed with avocado and tomato and that stringy cheese too. Okay. Mm. The avocado, so fresh. Wow, that masa, that corn flour dough, again, so crispy and crunchy. Just all the ingredients, the tomatoes, the avocado, again, just give it such a fresh taste. Can't really taste the beef, but I love the addition of the cheese too. Even though it's not melted, it adds a certain creamy and milkiness to the memela. Mm. A perfect breakfast and the ultimate way to start our Oaxacan street food tour here in Oaxaca. And let's end with an ultimate memela bite. Love this cheese.
Muchas, muchas gracias.
Riquísimo. Hasta luego. Oh, so delicious. What a great local spot.
Next stop is for a local Oaxacan torta that was actually invented here. Come on.
mayonnaise?
Yeah, sí. Ah. Mayonnaise. Turkey ham.
Turkey ham.
You know?
Yes, we love it.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Oh, that Oaxacan cheese. So stringy.
Oaxacan sausage?
Exactly.
Oh, and fresh avocado, wow.
Oh, chicharron, yes, yeah. We love as well.
Oh, more meat as well.
Frijoles?
Yes. And the final touch is the homemade sauce.
Oh, and the special salsa. Wow.
Oaxaqueña salsa.
From my mom.
Her recipe, right?
Yeah.
Oh, bellissimo! We're here at Torta Oaxaqueña for their Torta Oaxaqueña. Now this place has been around since 1985 making delicious torta, and this is the one they are known for. What makes it special is this fresh bread that they use for the torta, as well as their secret homemade sweet and spicy chipotle salsa. And we were told by one of the owner's son here that his mother actually invented the recipe for the salsa. And look how packed it is with all those fresh ingredients. We've got the turkey ham, the quesillo Oaxacan cheese, the sausage, the avocado, that salsa, chicharron on there, frijoles, beans. There's just so much on this torta. And that bread smells so nice and fresh. All right, this looks so good. That first bite is pretty much just all ham and cheese, and I am loving it. That bread though is so fresh and crispy. When you bite into it, it's just nice and crispy on the outside, soft and doughy on the inside. Oh, that was just perfect. I want to get a taste of this special salsa. Chicharron. Oh, that salsa has such a smokiness to it, the chipotle. It's nice and spicy, but a little bit sweet too. Gives it such a nice flavor. Wow, definitely a special recipe. And this sausage in there too, look at that. It is just so red. Ooh, it's got a nice meaty flavor to it actually. It's not very spicy, even though it looks like it probably would be because it's red. But that is tasty. There's just like a lot of different kinds of meat in here, which is really nice, with the chicharron, the turkey ham, and that sausage in there. Just gives it a lot of nice salty flavor, but with the freshness of the cheese and that avocado and the beans too, there's a lot of veggies in there as well. So it's actually a really well-balanced sandwich. And that bread is just incredible. I love that chicharron in there too. And can't forget, we got a mundet to go with our drink. Now this is a apple pop, which is really popular here in Mexico, and we actually haven't tried yet, which we can't believe. So it's a hot day here in Oaxaca, and something refreshing is definitely what we need. Ooh, actually that's quite nice. It's like a fizzy apple juice. This is such a traditional drink. It's really popular with locals. It's been around for more than 100 years. That's really refreshing.
Apple soda? That sounds awesome.
Actually goes really well with the sandwich because that sweetness just cuts any saltiness with it. But so great coming to places like this that are local and family run. Tortas Oaxaqueña has been around since 1985, almost 40 years now, making these delicious tortas. And they are massive. You get such a big one for an affordable price. So this is definitely somewhere you have to visit to try their incredible tortas. Honestly, one of the best I think we've had. So good. Muy rico. Delicioso. Gracias. Just so tasty.
Gracias.
God, that is a big scoop.
We're here at Nieves Chagmita, which is a legendary spot in the Mercado Benito Juarez, and they specialize in nieves, which translates to snow, and this is a popular sorbet that you find especially in Oaxaca, and what makes them special is they have very interesting flavors. So we got leche quemada con tuna, which is a burnt milk flavor with the fruit of the prickly pear cactus, and this place has been around for over 200 years selling their ice cream, so it is just the spot to try it. And these flavors, honestly, I'm just dying to try this burnt milk flavor. Okay, let's see here. You can see it's actually quite like a sorbet. It's milky, but it's also a bit more watery than like a creamy ice cream. All right. Wow. Okay. That is extremely interesting. So the first thing that hits you is it's milky, but then it honestly kind of tastes like fire. It has such a smokiness to it, but it's honestly like eating a mouthful of smoke, which sounds kind of weird, but it actually works with the milk. That's really interesting, super unique. Wow, that's very unique. Oh, muchas gracias. And that is the owner here. She is one of, I don't know what generation they're on now, after 200 years. She's such a sweet, friendly lady. Has been so nice to us since we arrived. And it looks like we've got what looks like an empanada type of a treat here. And this, I believe it's barquillo or something like that, but it's like a cone full of custard. So we're definitely gonna need to try that with our ice cream here, but I wanna dig into the prickly pear before it melts. Look at that, that nice red color there. And you can see the little spots from the fruit too. Oh, okay, that is incredible. It actually tastes like a sweet watermelon or something like that. It's kind of watery, but so refreshing on the hot day here in Oaxaca. Oh, I really like that. Okay, gotta get a taste with both of them.
Ultimate bite.
Ultimate nieves bite. Okay, that's a nice combo. The sweetness of the prickly pear really contrasts with the smokiness of that ice cream, which again is still so unique. I can't get over that. But this is refreshing. I like ice cream, but honestly, I think if I had to choose, I would go for a sorbet any day because it's just more refreshing to me. Oh, that's so good.
Muy rico.
Muy rico. I love this. Look at this barquillo con crema. It is pretty much an ice cream cone, just full of a creamy custard. The outer layer there is actually quite thick. Look at that. And it almost has, oh wow, look at that. It really is like a custard inside of there. Oh my gosh, it's like, wow, what an interesting texture. It's like, like a jelly, look at it jiggle. I think there must be cinnamon or something in there because it's got quite a nice flavor to it. The owner did say you should mix the two of them together, so maybe we'll just put a little bit of ice cream on top here for extra flavor. Ooh, okay, that burnt milk pretty much takes over any kind of flavor of this barquillo. I like it. And onto our empanada. Look at this flaky guy. Oh yeah, look at that. Looks like we've got lots of cream in there, just like that creamy custard in the barquillo. Oh my gosh, and this is so flaky. All right, I'm just gonna dunk this guy in actually. See. I think I might like this empanada more because the pastry that they use is so flaky.
It's almost somewhere between a pastry and a croissant, actually. So nice to try such a unique ice cream here in Oaxaca City at especially such a legendary place here in the market. Again, I can't believe this place has been around for 200 years, probably on six generations or something like that. And just such a historical place that you have to visit, because I can't get over how unique these flavors of ice cream are. And sorbet is always a win for me.
Hola, buenas tardes. Chapulines?
Chapulines.
Grasshoppers. So one thing that is super abundant here in Oaxaca are bugs. Now, grasshoppers and ants especially are the most common you can see all over the city. They're used in dishes. You can eat them alone. In the market, you can buy them. You can see them all over the place in the city. And just look on the side of the street here, this wonderful stall has a whole ton of chapulines, which are the grasshoppers. It looks like there's a whole bunch of different ones. I don't know what they are, but we should definitely get some. Muchas gracias. Gracias. So we got a bag of mixed chapulines, which is a mixed bag of the grasshoppers. There's a whole bunch of different kinds here. So we have chili, garlic, and lemon. And you can see here as well, there's baby grasshoppers, we were told as well. So there is a whole ton of grasshoppers here. And these look tasty, so we should probably just give them a try right here on the street.
That's a hefty bag.
That is a pretty big bag.
Yeah.
Looks like we got some peanuts in there too.
Oh, nice.
I love peanuts, so that's gonna go well with those grasshoppers. Oh, these grasshoppers smell so good. It honestly smells like chili garlic chips, like potato chips. And look at that. The bag is absolutely filled with them. These guys are so big. They look so big, all different shapes and sizes. We didn't get any of the baby ones, so we got the full adult chapuline grasshoppers there.
Woo.
Look at that. And again, three different flavors, so let's just give them a try. Cheers. That's a chili one? Woo! Spicy! Oh! Rico! Muy rico! Picante! Oh! That's spicy, but those are so delicious. Crispy, crunchy, salty. Oh! So flavorful. We've never had grasshoppers or bugs before, which we have, and we actually quite like them. Like this, at least. They are just full of flavor. They're not really soft and like juicy, squidgy. So if you're kind of squeamish, then these are definitely for you because they're just crunchy deliciousness, full of flavor and packed with protein as well. Oh, so, so good. Look at those legs.
These are big grasshoppers.
They are big. Mmm, that was a garlic one. Super garlicky. Oh my gosh. We've got some peanuts to go with it. Mmm. Nice salty garlicky peanuts. Oh, the perfect complement to these grasshoppers. I could just stand here and eat these all day. This is the perfect snack here in Oaxaca on the street. Mmm. Muy muy rico. So many. So delicious. Delicioso. Oh wow. Chicatanas? Oh, so here we have the chicatanas, which are the flying ants. This is the other really popular bug here in Oaxaca besides the grasshoppers. You can see there, they're almost like roly, circular ball ants there. Look at these little ants.
Those are big ants.
They're so round. All right, here we go. Mmm, little less flavor. Very crunchy. A bit more juicy, to be honest, than the grasshoppers. I'd have to say, I think I like the grasshoppers better, but these ants, nice to try as well. I think we'll stick to our chapulines, though. Mm, way less juicy. Oh, what's this one called? Name? Gustado? So I think these are the like larvae in the agave plants.
Oh, they're the worms.
Oh, yeah, the worms.
Yeah.
Not larva, sorry, yeah, the worms. Look at those. Huh. They honestly just turn into nothing. It's almost like a shell. There's no inside to them. It's pretty hollow, if you can see that. Mmm. Very interesting. It has more of like a bug taste, if you could picture that. A bit more like earthy. I'd say those are definitely more bug tasting than the chapuline grasshoppers. All in all though, what a great bug experience here.
We're here inside of La Soledad, which is a mole and chocolate shop that's been around since 1930, and they make all their own chocolate and cacao here from natural cacao beans that are sourced right here in Mexico. So we're really lucky today because we're gonna get to watch the process of how they grind the cacao beans and the first processes of making their chocolate. So I think it's gonna be starting over here, so let's get to it. Cinnamon, cacao, almond, and cinnamon. Oh, wow. This is the bitter chocolate, so just the cacao, the cinnamon, and the almonds. Ooh, that is bitter. That's very bitter, and it's like peanut butter. Mmm, rico. It sticks to your teeth. You do not get any fresher than this. Just fresh cacao ground up, and that cinnamon and the almond with it too gives it a nice flavor. Oh my gosh, I have never had chocolate this fresh before in my whole entire life.
With sugar, they clean it with the rest of the cacao.
They clean the chocolate machine with sugar.
The chocolate is mixed with all the sugar to make their traditional chocolate. So now this is the same, but with the sugar added to it. So it's very different. It's almost granular. Look at that. And there was a lot of sugar added in. Looks so different than just the cacao paste once you add the sugar to it. All right. Mmm. Sugar definitely tastes that bitterness away. Still kind of like peanut butter, but oh, you can really taste the cinnamon in there. Oh wow, that is muy rico. Oh, fresh chocolate like that, oh, it doesn't get any better. Oh,
what a cool process too.
Wow, yeah, so traditional. Mm.
Mexico is the birthplace of chocolate, with 4,000 years of delicious history. The Olmecs were the original chocolatiers, first turning the cacao plant into an ancient chocolate drink used in rituals and medicine. The Mayans and Aztecs believed it to be a sacred gift from the gods, even using cacao as currency. The Europeans after them added sugar, eventually evolving chocolate into what we know and love today. Over time, Oaxaca's location on an ancient trade route made it an important center for chocolate production, producing some of the best traditional chocolate in Mexico, even though cacao trees are not grown here. There may now be numerous chocolatiers throughout the city, but La Soledad is one of the originals. This family-run business has been around since the 1930s. Their traditional artisanal process of making chocolate with high-quality local ingredients is what brings customers back time and again. On the one side of La Soledad, they are making all the chocolate and selling it just raw like this. And then on the other side over here, they have their made chocolate that they sell at their store. So let's take a look at what they've got over here.
Chile with ginger, with cardamom.
Oh wow.
With beans, with orange, with anise, and with cayenne.
Oh wow, wow. Loads of different flavors of chocolate that they do here, so it's quite unique compared to some of the other shops around. But I'm gonna taste a few of the other different ones. We've got a mocha here with coffee in it. Okay. Look at these cute little samples we've got here. Oh, and it's like a little coffee bean. Look at that. Super cool. Mmm. Oh, okay, that is nice. Has such a strong coffee flavor to it. I love chocolate coffee. Not only do they specialize in chocolate here, but they also do mole. Now, this is one of the most important sauces that you find in Mexico, especially here in Oaxaca. They have some high quality mole here, and chocolate is one of the main ingredients. So they do three different kinds here, the negro, rojo, and coloradito, which is the black, red, and little red. So I'm just gonna dig in and start with this black mole for a taste. Now this is such a rich, complex sauce, and you can just see there, the color on it, just how thick it is. Mmm. Oh, that is delicious. Nice amount of spice to it. The chocolate is very mild, but oh, okay, that one's got a really nice kick to it. Just so flavorful and rich. I'm gonna go in for the rojo. Mmm. Oh, it has much of a different flavor than the black. It's definitely milder, it's not as spicy as the black one. I just love how here in Mexico, chocolate is so versatile. They use it in so many different sauces. It's not just something you get from the store and eat in a bar, so it really adds so much rich flavor to everything. And it makes sense because after being around for 4,000 years, you'd think they'd realize how to use their chocolate in so many different ways. So we could stand around and just sample all this chocolate all day, but we came here for something very special, so let's head back into the kitchen and get that made. Here we have our chocolate de olla, which is a traditional Oaxaca hot chocolate. And I'm not gonna lie, I thought we were gonna get a cup, but this is a bowl. Look at the size of this hot chocolate. And I love the traditional way that they make it with the milanillo, how they whisk it up like that. It's so cool and it just gets it so frothy. Now on the side, we have a pan de yema. Now this is a traditional bread here in Oaxaca, and it is like a brioche eggy type of a sweet bread. And just look at the color inside of that. So yellow and so fresh. Okay, so you've gotta have your hot chocolate, dipping your bread in it, but I first just need to taste this hot chocolate because it just looks frothy, incredible, and oh, it is so rich smelling. Okay, cheers. Oh my gosh, that just tastes like pure melted chocolate. You can really taste the richness in it, as well as a little bitterness, because I believe they just use the straight chocolate tablets of just that organic chocolate powder, and oh my gosh. Mmm. Oh, that is incredible. Let's get a taste with this bread, because I need to soak this bread up with this chocolate. Let's get a nice dip, ooh, of this bread in this chocolate here. Just look at that. That is a soaked piece of bread. Mmm, that's nice, interesting. It's different because usually you don't dip bread like this into a hot chocolate, but it kind of works. The sweetness of the chocolate goes with this bread because it's a very different kind of a texture actually. A little sweet and kind of eggy, you can see with the color there, but I like this. It's a good combo and it makes that bread, oh, look at that, just so soft and soaked with that chocolate. Mmm. It's like a little chocolate explosion when you bite into it. Mmm, that is incredible. We got ours made with milk, and here in Oaxaca, you can get it made with either water or milk. I guess unless you're lactose intolerant, you probably gonna go with the water, but we do love a milky hot chocolate, and oh, mmm. It really does just make it that little bit more creamy and rich.
and just so velvety. What makes La Soledad unique compared to some of the other chocolate shops around here is they have the shop in the front, the restaurant here in the back, and they're actually a hotel upstairs. So it's a really great place to come and experience the chocolate culture here in Oaxaca.
Mexico is famous for their chocolate. You can get it all over the country, but no city is more famous than Oaxaca for their chocolate. So you must try as much chocolate as you humanly possibly can while you're here in Oaxaca. And I think we're doing a pretty good job so far.
Chapinita, which is a super local spot here in Oaxaca City. You can see we are literally on the street, on the road. There are cars driving by. This place is packed tonight, and we are here to try the pozole de Oaxaca and their delicious pork tostada. Both of these look amazing, but we want to try the star of the show, which is this pozole. So this is pozole, which is a pork soup, and it's made with pork and hominy, which is a dried corn that is soaked in the mineral bath, and it actually doubles the corn kernels in size, and they top it off with guacamole and as well as a lot of pieces of the pork here. This looks delicious, so I'm just gonna give it a nice mix up first. Oh wow, there are so many ingredients here, and I think they sprinkled it with cabbage as well. This looks really, really tasty. Wow, look how many ingredients are in there. Oh my gosh. Okay, cheers. Wow, that is a rich soup. Holy moly. The pork is absolutely super fatty, tender, and those hominy, dried corn kernels, are really, really interesting. They're really soft, almost reminds me of like a chickpea, but just adds so much flavor. That pork though, super tender and juicy. The richness of the broth just has such a nice, subtle, salty flavor, to be honest. A really interesting bowl of soup and really hearty as well. The crunchy cabbage adds a super nice crunchy taste to this soup. A slight taste of corn, but honestly, the star is definitely that pork meat. The guacamole gets really lost in this, but it's not spicy or anything. The perfect soup, to be honest, on a hot night tonight. Almost forgot, we were told to add a little bit of lime into our pozole here too. So, give that a mix. And we were given these huge tortillas to go with it, so let's just scoop a little bit of this pozole on. All right. So crunchy. A nice tangy zing to the pozole. This is delicious. Moving on to this monster pork tostada. Look at the size of this. This is really, really heavy. It is covered with that guacamole with cabbage and that delicious, tender, juicy pork as well. Oh my goodness, this is huge. Let's squeeze some lime on. And what this stall is known for is their very, very spicy and orange habanero salsa. First, we have a salsa verde, so we'll put a little bit of that on. But we were told this is the star of everything here to go with their pork tacos, their pork tostadas, maybe even with the pozole, but let's put it on the pork tostada here. Okay. That is orange in color there. That smells spicy. Super huge pork tostada bite. Oh man, that is spicy. Woo. That is delicious though. You can just see how filled that pork tostada is. The guacamole on the bottom, the cabbage as well as all of that pork. And look how orange that salsa is. That is a spicy salsa. I'm starting to sweat, but it's actually really delicious. Oh, my lips are burning. Again, the pork is super tender. You can see that there are really fatty pieces as well because he includes the cheek meat. So delicious. Oh, it's really spicy. So hot. My lips are on fire. Got doggy friends here as well. Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy.
Good night. Good night. You want some spicy pastata?
Careful.
No, this is ours. That's gonna hurt your stomach. He doesn't want spicy lips like me. So much pork here, such big juicy pieces, and they're cutting up so much. They have buckets and buckets full of pork for tonight's dinner service. Melt in your mouth. This is the ultimate street food experience here in Oaxaca City, sitting on the road here, eating these delicious tostadas and the pozole. This is a definite must when you're here in Oaxaca City. Since 1960, this stall has been selling this delicious food. Over 60 years. Let's end with an ultimate bite. Let's put our pozole on there. Let's add a little bit of that super, super lip burning habanero salsa. Ooh. Street food at its finest here in Mexico. Oh, that was good. All right, everyone, that does it for our first day here in Oaxaca. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the bell icon below to get notified when we post a new video, and make sure you subscribe to our channel to join us on all of our food adventures. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.